Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode, we have a further delay to the launch of Starlink 9 plus Demo 2 and Tom Cruise information. Then, as always, we have a bunch of updates in Boca Chica, SN5 successful static fire, SN7.1 and some new Starship pieces. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As I said, the launch of Starlink 9 with two Black Sky satellites has been delayed once again due to weather. If you want to stay updated with launch dates, check out the SpaceXFans website, there's a link in the description. As most of you will know, Bob Benkhen and Doug Hurley launched to the ISS a couple of months ago. As you will probably be aware, they've already departed from the station. Jim Bridenstine tweeted that NASA teams are currently go for landing from a weather standpoint, something that's been a bit of a concern recently. Here's the video of Crew Dragon departing from the International Space Station. In terms of landing zones and weather, I believe a couple of the areas are expected to have some bad weather. Eric Berger tweeted about it and said, "Latest run of European model shows a tropical storm near Kennedy Space Center on Sunday afternoon. Winds may be acceptable at Pensacola and Panama City landing sites though. So hopefully today at 2:42pm EDT or 6:42pm UTC, the two astronauts should splash down." To finish up the SpaceX updates, we have a bit of news about the mission to the ISS where Tom Cruise will be filming. Apparently, the budget for the film is $200 million and Tom Cruise and Doug Liman will be making the journey. With those updates covered, let's head over to Boca Chica and check out what's been happening. Recently, we saw work starting on an area with an old gas well. Here you can see workers have been continuing to work over there. Over by the test area, a whole load of activity has been taking place in recent months. They've been seen doing some more digging and groundwork near to the test mount. I believe that this is where they were last spotted removing the fence. Here we have a better view of the work they're currently doing over there. Looks like they could possibly be planning to add more shipping containers, potentially as offices. As we've also seen recently, engineers were also captured working on Starhopper modifications and more. They've also been spotted continuing work over by the new cafe or food court area. Those Starship fins really do look awesome. Also spotted, we have a transport mount which has lights attached to it, and Jack Beyer suggested maybe for display. Now, I'm going to do some speculating here and say, what if SN2 is being worked on to go on display over by this restaurant area? Just an idea, but I think that would be cool. Workers were also spotted doing some stuff with the roll lift, which is used for transporting Starship prototypes. Whilst I'm not sure of the plan, it's been placed down by the food court next to the roll lift, which is interesting. In the production area of the facility, SpaceXers have been busy doing a variety of things. Firstly, you can see that they were spotted doing some welding work on a new transport mount. Then, a different transport mount was spotted being transported, lots of transporting going on. This one is usually used for moving sections around the yard. Also captured in a construction yard is this interesting new metal panel. Currently, it's unclear what it's for, but like with everything, we might find out soon enough. Something else we've seen being worked on recently is the additional structure being added to the ground fabrication building. Workers were spotted adding a roof, and so this is now looking near enough complete. Bluezilla had to be put out of action with the recent tropical storm, and so the high bay construction paused for a little bit. However, workers have since continued constructing it with a smaller crane. However, this little orange basket with men inside attached to a crane was seen being lifted up to Bluezilla. So they are currently in the process of getting this huge crane back into operation. Shouldn't be too much longer probably before we see the high bay start getting even taller. Since then, it appears that Bluezilla is already back up and should be ready to continue with construction soon. Now it's time to move on to the main event with news about Starship prototype SN5 and the static fire. As you would definitely know, the testing was postponed multiple times recently due to issues. However, on Thursday, SpaceX yet again began their testing attempt. Something that was spotted was a couple of dishes at the tracking area, both pointing at and communicating with the SN5 prototype. So, on Thursday, whilst they were going to attempt the firing pretty early into the test window, they had to abort. There was apparently a boat that had entered the exclusion zone, hence they had to wait before performing the test. However, later into the window on July 30th, the company performed the first static fire of the SN5 prototype with Raptor engine SN27 attached. After the test, Elon Musk obviously tweeted and said Starship SN5 just completed full duration static fire 150 meter hop soon. He then tweeted a reply which contained this picture of the static fire from their drone. After the static fire, which was obviously a success, the SN5 tank was seen standing tall on the test mount. However, it wasn't very long at all before engineers rolled back in to continue working on preparing the vehicle. As Musk mentioned, the 150 meter hop should be happening soon, and so you can see they are working on preparing for that test now. In terms of testing, like normal, we have the road closures posted by Cameron County, and there are some dates over the next few days. SpaceX apparently has some notices to airmen or NOTAM documents for August 2nd and August 3rd, so we could see the hop test happen today or tomorrow. However, we have some information on future testing to expect from SpaceX. The company had filed, and the FCC has approved, testing for up to 20 kilometers in altitude. The testing is authorized from August 18, 2020 until February 18, 2021, so very exciting news. Since SN5 has now been static fired and they are looking at hopping soon, let's take a look at other starships in the works. Firstly, not so much of a starship but counts nonetheless, we have the start of what should be SN7.1. Most of you will know that recently SpaceX did a test to failure of the SN7 tank made of 304L stainless steel. Well, here is the upper bulkhead and rings for the second SN7 tank. Before we finish up the video, let's just take a look at a bit more starship that has been spotted. Here we have a section that has been seen with similar reinforcements to thrust sections. However, I may be wrong here, but since then I believe this stack has been moved over to the scrap pile with another ring stack. Also spotted arriving in the production area was this new thrust puck. Whilst the SN8 prototype could already have a thrust puck, it's also possible that this new component is for SN8. Also seen moved out into the construction yard is this new bottom skirt for a thrust section. You can see the reinforcement welds and some welds for leg mounting points. Then, something else that was spotted moved outside is this new 4-ring stack which you can see has lead-ins. I'm going to say that this is likely a stack for the LOX tank of the SN8 prototype, which could indicate stacking quite soon. I'll also add this here, but here you can see the latest view of the nose cone area where SpaceX has quite the collection. Also, if you look just between the three noses, just above the bushes, there are a bunch of nose cone tips. Potentially for future Starship noses, also potentially for scrap, just gonna have to wait and see. I want to say a massive thank you to each and every person who has subscribed to this channel so far. I love keeping up to date with SpaceX, and to be able to share it with others, not least with 10,000 like-minded fans, is an honor. To see this much support means a lot to me, so I literally cannot thank you all enough. I've got a store coming very soon, it should be announced in my next video, so stay tuned. Obviously, none of my updates in this channel would be possible at all without the work of the NASA spaceflight team. Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, goes out pretty much every day for hours and hours on end, so we get to see history in the making. However, everybody at NSF puts in an incredible amount of work. So thanks to each and every one of you for your fantastic effort and dedication. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.